eye floaters are one of the most common eye problems that we face in our clinic. It is so prevalent that after the age of 40s, almost 70 to 80% people experience at least once, one or two episodes of seeing floaters. So what are these eye floaters and why do they form and what is the treatment? This is what we will discuss today. Hello, I am Dr. Sumeet Agrawal and you are watching Eye Health For You, where you get all the information about your eye health in a very simple language. Eye floaters are basically shadows which we see of the protein clumps which are formed inside the eye. What do we mean by this? Let's see the structure of the eye. So the eye comprises from front to back of the cornea, the iris, lens, and at the backmost part there is retina. Between the lens and the retina there is a gel which we call as vitreous gel. This gel is made out of protein and collagen and water. So in young age, this gel is of a very dense consistency. This is very thick and uniform in composition. As age increases, especially after the age of 20 years, this gel starts to liquefy. The protein parts get separated and the water part gets separated. This is called as vitreous degeneration. So with this degeneration, the protein part starts to form clumps. These clumps can be in the shape of a bunch of wires or in the shape of some strands like hair or even in the form of dots. So these protein clumps start forming and they start floating around inside the gel. As the eye moves, these particles also start moving. These particles form a shadow on the back part of the eye on the retina. This is exactly what we see as floaters. Floaters can be seen in very different shapes according to the shape of the protein clump, like in the form of dots, in the form of hair strands, in the form of a bunch. So these floaters start forming and these we see as eye floaters. Now what do these floaters mean? Are they harmful? Are they dangerous to our vision? So in one word, they are not dangerous, but whenever floaters are forming, then we should have a retina checkup. We should go to our retina specialist and have a detailed retina checkup. Now why is that? Because floaters means that there is some degenerative process going on inside the eye. Sometimes this kind of degeneration also affects the retina. There can be formation of holes or tears or some weak areas inside the retina. These areas are now a potential space where the retina can get torn or damaged even more, and then it can detach. Retinal detachment is a serious condition which causes permanent loss of vision. So whenever you see new floaters, you should always get a detailed retina checkup just to make sure that the retina is safe, there are no breaks or any weak areas inside the retina. If your retina is safe, then floaters are not at all anything you should worry about. One thing about floaters is that the more you notice them, the more you will see them. And if you try to ignore them, if you are busy with some other work, then the floaters will also be very less visible. So best option for floaters is to get a retina checkup, and if retina is okay, then if it is possible to ignore these floaters, that is the best option. Usually with time, the floaters settle down also. They settle down in the bottom part of the eye because of gravity, they are heavier. So in this gel, they gradually settle down. But in young age, the vitreous is dense. It is more of a gel consistency. So it may take few months up to a few years also for these floaters to go away. In older age, these tend to settle down faster because the vitreous is more of liquid and the floaters go down fast. Why do these floaters form? We have covered that. Sometimes because of injury or because of diabetes or because of there is some bleeding inside the gel, floaters can also form because of these things. So it is important to get your retina checked whenever you see new floaters. There is one more symptom associated with floaters, which is called as flashes. What are flashes? Flashes are basically a streak of lightning that we usually see in the periphery of our vision. This happens because there is some pull on the retina, there is some traction. That's why the retina gets pulled, and whenever retina gets pulled, it creates a light impulse which we see as flashes. So whenever there are flashes or new floaters, you should get a retina checkup. Make sure that your retina is not damaged or anywhere there is a weak area. If your retina is normal, then floaters are nothing to worry about. Just try to ignore them. Keep your hydration level good. Drink lots of water. Avoid rubbing the eye too much or bending or lifting very heavy weights suddenly with a jerk. These precautions will help make sure that the retina doesn't get damaged, and gradually with time the floaters will go on its own. Few drops, few tablets are sometimes given for these floaters. They help in faster absorption of the floaters. Some very particular cases where the number of floaters is very much and it's causing decrease in vision, it's causing a lot of trouble to the patient, there we offer a surgery that is called floater only vitrectomy. This surgery is very effective in removing the floaters, and it is very safe also. But we reserve it for the extreme cases where floaters are very much in number, they are causing a lot of visual problems. Because after all, surgery is a surgery, it may have a small risk of losing your vision or some other complications. So surgery is also an option for patients who are bothered by floaters, and it has very good results. But mostly floaters can be ignored, it is possible, and they usually go away on their own. Thank you for watching. You can leave your comments in the comment section. You can ask all your eye related questions there. I will try to answer each and every one of them. Thank you.